Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. On the SGI graph, we see earthquakes with magnitude 5.5 and larger. We see typical clustering of stronger earthquakes. It already happened on the 13th, following the lunar geometry that preceded that clustering. Then we have magnitude 6 earthquake on the 17th with the very critical planetary geometry. However, the lunar peak on the 15th is also part of that seismic increase. So far, no major seismic activity with the critical convergence of planetary geometry on the 15th, 16th and 17th. And then we have the lunar geometry again on the 19th. And it's very interesting that with the lunar geometry, the green peaks, we see the clustering of earthquakes following those peaks. And that happened on the 20th. Like I said, on the 20th, there could be a larger seismic activity because of that lunar geometry. And indeed, it peaked magnitude 6.5 near the north coast of New Guinea. And we also had some clustering on the 22nd, peaking magnitude 6.2 at Crete, Greece. And this is the second strong earthquake, actually. It also happened earlier on the 13th. Yes, it was also around 6.0, 6.1. And so there is some stress there that's being released, and there's stress redistribution there in the area. And this could be indicators of upcoming larger seismic activity in the region. These six magnitude earthquakes, they have everything to do with the Africa plate colliding with the Eurasia plate. And the microplates, this is the Aegean microplate and the Anatolia microplate, that's Turkey. So that's something to be aware of. And we also had a 6.1 magnitude earthquake at the Macquarie Islands region. And that is another strong earthquake south of New Zealand. Also something to be aware of. We had a magnitude 5 earthquake the other day in Australia that could be related. And this could also affect New Zealand in the short term. Okay, so let's get on with the next time frame. We have some critical geometry that is noteworthy. Later today, we have some convergence with Mars, Mercury, Neptune, followed by Earth, Mercury, Uranus. There could be some seismic increase as a result. Venus is not involved. It's really with Mercury here. We see that in the solar system, Mars, Mercury, Neptune, and Earth, Mercury, and Uranus in a conjunction. This is a tight convergence today, later today, and we could see a seismic response as a result. That could be tomorrow or the day after, within about 2 days. Then we have quite a clustering of planetary and lunar geometry coming up, especially from the 26th to the 28th. And we could see a seismic response as a result, the typical clustering of stronger earthquakes, especially from the 27th to the 30th. That is probably the most critical time in this time frame, from the 27th to the 30th. And that's because of the lunar peak that we have on the 26th, that's with Uranus. And there's probably going to be some seismic response in the higher 5 magnitude range, maybe magnitude 6, on the 27th. And we have a planetary geometry converging there, especially on the 28th. Three planetary conjunctions and a lunar conjunction. And that's probably the most critical geometry here. In the solar system, we see this lunar geometry. It is the green line. That's a lunar conjunction with Jupiter, always very significant. We have Mars, Sun, and Saturn in a conjunction. That is not really a critical conjunction, but it converges with the Sun, Mercury, and Uranus, and also Venus, Mercury, Jupiter. And that combination is really critical. So Venus, Mercury, Jupiter, and Sun, Mercury, Uranus. That is a tight convergence there. And it happens at the same time as the lunar conjunction with Jupiter. And that means that we're probably going to see an obvious seismic response on the 29th and the 30th. In the higher 5, maybe 6 magnitude range. And there could be a magnitude 7 in there around the 30th. Okay. We also have some geometry coming up there on the 30th. This is Mercury, Sun, Earth, not necessarily critical. Semi-right angle geometry on the 31st and the 1st of June. And then a lunar peak, is a lunar geometry with Mars on the 1st. And there could be some response there on the 2nd of June, but probably not much at this point. So be on watch, on extra alert from the 27th to the 30th in particular. I think that is the most critical time here in this time frame. If we look at atmospheric anomalies, we picked up quite a strong fluctuation that was on the 20th, and it marked the West Pacific. It went over Australia before the magnitude 5 earthquake occurred, and to the north of the Mariana Islands, and then up to the Bonin Islands south of Japan, also marked that area. And you might think, well, that is really a remote area in no man's land. But if a really large earthquake happens there and the potential is there, it will it may generate a tsunami, and that could affect coastal areas in the West Pacific. So that is not something to underestimate there. And the other side of the Earth, that is the Atlantic. The Atlantic is also possible, is also capable of producing magnitude 7 earthquakes. It's been a while, actually. We had a 6.8 recently south of Iceland, but on the Atlantic Ridge, there can be magnitude 7 earthquakes. So this is the update so far. Check out the website for the latest updates, atmospheric anomalies, and also the social media channels. This is the update for now. Stay safe. Until next time.